Welcome back to Glen Rock High. It may have been four decades since we roamed the hallways of this place, and there may have been a lot of changes, but in many ways, things are still the same. Glen Rock kids still worry about their next science test, and they wonder why they have to study things that they think they'll never use in real life, like algebra and trigonometry. And they agonize over whether that little red spot on the end of their nose is about to blossom into a giant pimple the day they're supposed to make a presentation before the entire class. But they also enjoy the special times and the special people that have made this an extraordinary place since it first opened in 1956. Today that seems like a long time ago. But the pedigree of Glen Rock High actually goes back much farther than that. In fact, it goes all the way back to 1894, when schools became the very reason that Glen Rock was formed in the first place. And this is the spot where it all began. The one-room brick schoolhouse at the corner of Rock Road and Ackerman Avenue. Back in 1894, the school was actually part of the Ridgewood school system. And as part of a consolidation move, Ridgewood wanted to transfer all of its students to a different school that was in the middle of Ridgewood several miles away. Well, as you might imagine, that didn't sit too well with local residents. So they decided to form their own town and their own school system, using territory that was part of both Ridgewood and Saddle River. However, once word got out about the plan, Ridgewood officials decided they would try to block the move and annex the land to make it part of their village. And that set off a race to the county clerk's office in Hackensack to see who could file the paperwork first. Fortunately, Glen Rock town fathers beat them to it by about a half an hour, but not before they made one last-minute change to the incorporation papers. They crossed out the originally proposed name of South Ridgewood and replaced it with the name Glen Rock. And the rest, as they say, is history, except for one thing. A little-known controversy that remains even to this day, and that involves the rock itself.
This is Glen Rock. This is the Glen Rock.
This large boulder weighs about 570 tons and is 42 feet long.
This says Glen Rock, Pama Chapura, or Stone from Heaven, supposed Indian council site. Town of Glen Rock took its name from it in 1894. This is not true. This rock came from Hawthorne. It came down Rock Road. Before it was Rock Road, it was Stone Road. And the Dutch farmers, the Van der Klok family and the Van Pienen family, they rolled the rock down the hill and it landed right here. It was an Italian family living here at the time. This is all that's left of their home, the basement foundation.
Despite the controversy about how the rock got to where it sits today, none of that got in the way of town fathers doing business. And among the first things they did was to set up their own school system. With enrollment expanding, they decided to build school number one in 1900. They spent $4,000 to build it on a lot adjacent to the location of today's Central School. By the way, the total school budget for that year, for the principal, teachers, a janitor, and books was $1,880. By comparison, in 2014, Glenrock's school budget would total almost $50 million, or roughly $4,500 for every resident. But Glenrock was continuing to grow in popularity, so school number two was built next in 1915. Its name would later be changed to the Richard E. Byrd School in honor of the famed polar explorer. This was followed in 1926 with the construction of Central School, which also served for a time as the junior high. By the 1950s, the post-World War II baby boom was well underway, and it was soon clear that even more classroom space would be needed by the Glenrock school system. St. Catherine's School then opened its doors to about 500 students in 1953, with Coleman School being added to the public system the following year. 3 years later, in 1956, Glenrock High School was completed, and that finally ended the need for Glenrock's upperclassmen to attend Ridgewood High. The last addition to the Glenrock school system came in 1959, when Hamilton School was opened to alleviate overcrowding at both Central and Coleman schools. And so, as Glenrock entered the 1960s, our town, as we would come to know it, would be complete. Don't go away, because we have more Glenrock High School memories coming right up, right after this word from our sponsor.
Fuming drivers, bumper-to-bumper traffic, overheated engines, toll booth every quarter mile, all happening this Sunday!
Sunday
on the Garden State Parkway, 8-way traffic jam starting at 2 p.m. See Big Daddy Bob McGraw with his two car sick kids inching up the parkway in his 3-out-of-8-cylinder Country Squire.
See State Trooper Larry Daly rear end a pedal truck.
See a Puerto Rican family changing tires in the fast lane.
See Sister Mary McNeddigal back up 80 yards to the exit ramp.
All happening this Sunday!
Sunday
on the Garden State Parkway, 8-way traffic jam starting at 2 p.m. south of exit 145. Take Route 1 east to Route 2 south, then Route 3 north to Route 4 west. Back up two routes to the Garden State Parkway. Park your car in the middle lane and start a traffic jam of your own. Sunday on the Garden State Parkway. Be there!
Thank you. For those of us growing up in the 50s and 60s, it was a special time. Instead of video games, we had hula hoops. And instead of iPods, PlayStations, and 600 cable channels to choose from, we had just six TV stations to entertain us. Still, we found lots of pleasure in watching programs that featured the likes of Officer Joe Bolton, Captain Jack McCarthy, Chuck McCann, Soupy Sales, and of course the favorite of many kids, Sandy Becker.
What's light as a cloud, and fluffy too, and really white inside? Well, and very close by, we have it right here. It's called a Hostess Twinkie. Yes, Hostess Twinkies. White inside, I should say. Creamed fillings. Indeed. Look at the inside. The inside is full of white cream fillings of ever so good. Now, children, don't do as I'm doing because you'll fuck up the house.
We may have had six TV stations to choose from in the 1960s, but we really had just two radio stations if we wanted to hear the latest top 40 hits. But they played a big part in our lives.
The All-American Go-Go Teams on 77 WABC.
Sounds in America.
WABC. So everybody, your cousin Bruce is telling you that it's going to be a gorgeous day tomorrow, and I'm going to play a great record right now. How about something by Elvis? I love Elvis. Listen to this. And listen, while the Elvis record is playing, cousins, I want to say something to all my friends at Glen Rock High School at your first ever reunion. Congratulations to all the classes attending, and I wish I could be there in person, but this, I guess, is the second best thing, you know, being there electronically anyhow. We have great memories we share together, and cousins, we'll keep those memories alive. Your cousin Brucey promises you. Glen Rock High School, rock on!
This is the Glen Rock we knew and loved growing up. At first glance, it seems nothing much has changed. There's the Rock, the Pink Bank, Kilroy's, and trains running through town every few minutes. But then you look a little closer. That's when you realize that things aren't quite the same. Where there used to be a gas station, now there's a Starbucks. And where two gas stations used to be across the street, there's now something called the Galleria. And although it is still called the Sweet Shop, Dot and Isidore Scher have long left the building. But despite the changes, it's still Glen Rock, even if it's not quite the same.
This is the famous Wilkes. It's still here.
Yeah.
How are you folks?
Good.
We're from Glen Rock. We're the class of 68, 9, and 70 doing a little documentary on the town. And I used to come in here all the time and used to have that big barrel of pickles. I don't see them. The pickles?
Yeah, that was a long time ago.
Right oh, that's
there.
Them.
Yeah.
Look at those pickles. Yeah. Look how big that is. How much is that?
$150.
Last time I was here, I paid a nickel. When was that? August 8th, 1969.
Wow.
It was a nickel. Now it's $1.85, you said?
No, $150.
$150?
Yeah.
$150 for a pickle. It was a nickel to pickle.
Come on.
Hey. What are you doing to me? This is the Glen Rock Inn.
For you, it's a Glen Rock Out.
Remember what was in here, the tube testing machine? You guys will remember when I tell you. We used to go in with tubes from the TVs and radio,
and
then
the
week replace, okay?
Oh,
and
right.
The kids would stick the tubes in, and the arm would go, and it'd tell you if the tube was any good. You remember that. We used to come here at night with bags of tubes.
Bags of tubes.
But my mother and father wanted privacy in the house. Go check the tubes. Tube testing machine, I'm going to show you where it was. It's tubes right here, like right here. Where did they put the tube testing machine? The tube testing machine.
I don't know what a tube testing machine is.
You don't know what it is? Tubes from the TVs and radios? They had a tube testing machine here in the 1960s.
Oh, 1960s.
Yeah, but we lived here.
That's a long time ago.
Not for us, it isn't. I'm going to ask him questions. Follow me in. Hi. How's everybody? We're looking for the bike shop.
Yeah.
Six. Seven. Seven, no. Do I hear eight? Ah, that's it, seven, I'm in money. We can still count the cars by ear in Glen Rock. It's a skill we develop when you live between two railroad tracks. We are at Kilroy's, where everybody knows what this is. Take one at a time. Well, here's how I take one. One like this. And
hey, you, one at a time. Bring that back.
Oh, I thought it meant one bucket at a time. We're here. We have a new business opening here on Rock Road in the heart of downtown Glen Rock. Hello, folks. What is the kind of business are you going to open here?
A nail store.
Nail salon?
Yeah, nail salon.
I see. And do you have a name for it yet? What is it going to be called?
Fifi Nails.
Where are you people from?
Glen Rock.
Glen Rock?
Yes.
Yes, yes. I can tell by the accent, yes. Here we are at the Glen Rock Cleaners. How are you, sir? Are you
thank you very much.
Are you the owner here?
Yes, I'm owner.
And Mr. Sue, where are you from?
I came from the Glen Rock, New Jersey.
Glen Rock, New Jersey?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Yeah, Glen Rock, New Jersey.
Glen Rock, New Jersey. Yeah, I can tell by the accent. Here we are at Rock Fuji, a beautiful restaurant in the downtown Glen Rock, New Jersey. And we are with you. What is your name?
Matthew. Yes, sir.
And where do you come from?
Glen Rock.
From where?
Glen Rock.
Oh, yes, Glen Rock. Yes, I can tell by the accent. Yeah. Veramente italiano.
Veramente italiano.
De che parte italiano?
100% siciliano.
Siciliano? Sicilia proprio?
Sicilia.
Palermo?
Palermo?
Come? Alcamo?
Sapete
dove? No, proprio padre mio.
Provincia di Trapani.
Ma ci capisci? Io sono Florio Vivino, mi chiamo.
Ma you got the Naples accent.
La mamma mia è nata qui in Monte Gorgi, vicino Salerno. Io sono cassettani, cilindrani e calabrese. Veramente paesano. Boh, questo è un paesano nostro. Ma che fate venire?
Io vengo da Avellino, Napoli.
Ah, Avellino. Ah, conosci Salerno.
Salerno.
La mamma mia è nata qui in provincia di Cilindano.
Cilindano.
I terri di Melenzano a Cossi, Ruonco.
Sì, bello.
Sì. Con una fronda di limone in un goffo. Questa è una cosa speciale. My God, there's so many Italians. I would have stayed in town if I knew this many Italians. I could have been mayor.
Indeed, Glen Rock may have changed a bit since the days when we were growing up there. But there's comfort in knowing that some things never seem to change. That some moments and some people seem frozen in time.
Yes.
Here we go. It's yours. It's yours. It's mine. It's yours. It's yours. It's mine. This is great. Free smokes, and I haven't bought a pack in 25 years thanks to Two Door. Let's keep it open.
What do you think you're doing?
I'm just returning this book.
So this book was due May 7th, 1969. There's gonna be some fines. I'm sorry, it's gonna cost you $68,690.70.
Okay, I'll be right back.
High schoolers.
Eddie! Eddie Dyker, is that you? What are you doing over here?
Are you kidding me? I've been here since 1969. She's just not gonna let me go.
What are you talking about? Who won't let you go?
This woodman, she just won't let me go. She keeps an eye on me every minute, anything I'm doing.
Hey, Eddie, I think it's okay. I think she'll let you go. I think time is over, okay? Nothing but phone.
And so as we complete our journey back, we give thanks to those incredible times we spent in Glen Rock. We developed friendships that last until this very day. And we enjoyed opportunities that have made us who we are today. Success, large and small, has been the hallmark of all of our Glen Rock classmates. So let's take a moment to look at a small representative sample of the accomplishments of those we graduated with. Roy Lott left Glen Rock to become a leader in the record industry, rising to the top ranks of both Capitol and Arista Records. Today, Roy continues his work as an independent record producer, discovering new talent, such as this, his latest find, Herman Glimshire and the Vomiteers. Bob Viglione and Steve Hessen went on to become master carpenters.
Looks all right to me.
And Bob Schwarz, who became the first ever poster child for AARP. Another one of our classmates who's really made a mark in his field is Mike Dervis, who went into the retail business. Retail clothing, retail department stores, and his expertise was behind this mall in upstate New York. One of the classic Dervis properties where his marketing expertise has taken it to new heights. Good job, Mike. Another classmate who's demonstrated great success in his chosen field is Ron Polo, well known around the world for his custom design of electronic circuits and electrical devices. Irma Jennings of the class of 1970 became a holistic food coach, promoting her own brand of healthy eating, with amazing results as seen here. And Bob Koch, an industry leader who has specialized in electric generation and nuclear power plants. And last but not least, our very own Uncle Floyd Vivino, star of television, radio, motion pictures, and live entertainment, who continues to thrill audiences today with his unique style of comedy.
Hey, everybody, thank you so much. Thank you so much. It's wonderful to be here. So happy to be back in Glen Rock and see so many familiar faces. I'm touched by this turnout. I am touched by this turnout, and I thank you for, you had so many things to do, and you may have seen me in the movies. I go every Thursday. I'm proud to be an Okie from Muskogee. That's it. Here we go, a place where events can have a ball. We still wave old glory down at the courthouse in Muskogee, Oklahoma, USA. Hey, thank you very much. Hold the applause, please, folks. Please hold the applause. Thank you so much.
We'll meet
again. Don't know where, don't know when, but I know we'll meet again some sunny day. Keep smiling through, just like you always do, till the blue skies drive the dark clouds far away. And will you please say hello to the folks that I know? Tell them that I won't be long, and they'll be happy to know that as you saw me go, I was singing this song. We'll meet again. Don't know where, don't know when, but I know we'll meet again some sunny day. Yeah, we'll meet again. I don't know where, and I don't know when, but I do know that we'll meet again some sunny day. So honey, keep on smiling through, just like you always do, till the blue skies drive the dark clouds far away. And would you please say hello to all the folks that I know, and tell them I won't be long. They'll be happy to know that as you saw me go, I was singing this song.
We'll meet again. Don't know where, don't know when, but I know we'll meet again some sunny day.
Coming back. Get your walkers, get your canes, your easy shoes, and let's go back to our roots, Glen Rock. This is the most stupid thing I've ever done.